What's going on, guys? Living Zombies here, back with another Pokemon Go video. And in today's video, guys, yes, the new biome feature did go live for all players in the game. So with this feature does come some cool, unique backgrounds for Pokemon encounters, as you guys see right here. It also does work for PvP battles too, which is pretty sick. So yeah, this feature, if you guys have seen this being tested in other countries such as New Zealand, Australia, yes, this feature has finally been released globally. So you guys do have access to this cool new feature in the game right now. So yeah, with this new biome feature, guys, does come a celebration event for the Kanto region. So starting today until May 9th at 8 p.m. PST, this Kanto event will be taking place in the game. And with this event does come some new event bonuses, such as increased XP for 7-day Pokestop streak and Pokemon catch streak. Also, friendship levels will increase faster, which is pretty sick. And yeah, shiny boosted rates on Bulbasaur, Charmander, and Squirtle. So I did kind of see that coming, them shiny boosting the Gen 1 starters. I'm assuming a 1 in 125 shiny rate on the starters in this event, but I was hoping they would boost a few other Pokemon, not just the starters, but it does seem like it is just the starters. And speaking of the starters too, guys, if you do evolve them into their final evolutions, they will receive their C-Day legacy moves, Frenzy Plant, Blast Burn, Hydro Cannon. So yeah, those are available too during this time frame. Field research task rewards do include Mega Energy for Venusaur, Charizard, Blastoise. I was hoping for some Pokemon encounters too, but yeah, it is just going to be for Mega Energy for those Megas. And there will be a free special research that does give you guys some items, XP, Stardust, and some Kanto Pokemon encounters too. Now, where can you find these starters and other Kanto Pokemon in biomes? Well, for the forest biome, you guys will be finding Pokemon such as Bulbasaur, Caterpie, Weedle, Oddish, and more. So I hope there are, you know, a few other Pokemon spawns too, just besides those. The beach biome is home to Squirtle, Psyduck, Seal, and Magikarp, and more. The mountain biome is for Sandshrew, Clefairy, Zubat, and Diglett. And the city biome is for Caterpie, Pidgey, Machop, Ghastly, and more. So I'm assuming for the mountain biome, that's where Charmander is too, if you guys do want to go after shiny Charmander, because again, it is shiny boosted in this event. And they do also mention too that towns and other populated areas are included in the city biome. So just for clarification over that. And out of nowhere, I didn't really expect this, they are debuting Wigglet for this Kanto event too. To celebrate this brand new biome feature, Wigglet can be found in the beach biome. So yes, you do have to go to a beach to find Wigglet. And yes, people have caught Wigglet already in the game. Here's a screenshot of that. So yeah, it is available right now in the game, but you guys have to go to a beach to find this new Paldea Pokemon. So yeah, guys, again, enjoy the new biome feature. It is a pretty cool feature in the game. And with this biome feature, again, does come some specific Pokemon spawns too from the Kanto region until May 9th, 8 p.m. PST. So yeah, guys, comment below your thoughts about the new biome feature and the debut of Wigglet for this event too. Let me know if you guys do find a Wigglet for your Pokemon Go account. Thank you guys for watching today's video. If you enjoyed, drop a like in the video, subscribe for more, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.